Welcome to the next installment of my lecture series for Economic Analysis of the Law. And in this one, I'm going to be taking a look at Chapter 8, which is entitled An Economic Theory of Contracts. And in particular, I'm going to be looking at figures 8.1 and 8.2, just to go over the figures for you, hopefully to give you a better understanding of those particular figures. And in this, we're looking at an individual that we're going to refer to as the principal, and this individual has money that they want to invest. So they have two different strategies that they can engage in. One is simply they cannot invest that money. And if they don't invest that money, they get a payoff of zero because they didn't invest. And the person that they would engage to make the investment for them, the agent, also receives zero. Alternately, the principal can decide to invest with the agent. So they can invest a quantity of one with the agent. And now the agent themselves has a decision to make. What are they going to do? So let's just assume that there's only going to be two potential strategies for this individual. Let's assume, number one, that this individual could be dishonest and could walk off with the investment from the principal. This is referred to as appropriate. And appropriate is just a nice way of saying that they stole the money from them. So they promised to invest the money for them. They get the investment, and they walk off with it. And if you can see here, what's the payoff if the agent decides to appropriate? Well, the principal's out a dollar, so they have out one. So their payoff is negative one, while the agent gets a payoff of one because they walk off with that original investment. Alternately, the agent could also cooperate and actually invest the money. So let's assume that they do that and they cooperate, they invest that one unit and they get back two units. And we're assuming here that they're going to split the profits from that investment evenly. So there's a profit of one that's made from this investment and 0.5 goes to the principal here and 0.5 goes to the agent. So this is our payoffs in this game here. Let's take a look at what are the incentives for the agent? So if the principal decides to invest, which strategy maximizes the payoff for the agent? So if we take a look, what do they make if they walk off with the investment? They make one. So if they appropriate, they make one. If they decide to cooperate and actually invest the money and make money in this process, the agent makes 0.5. So from this perspective, if the principal invests, the agent is going to appropriate, and they're going to make one because that's better than making 0.5. All right? So make sure you understand that this, if the investment occurs, the agent's going to appropriate because they get a higher payoff. If we assume that the principal's aware of this, that there's a potential for appropriation by the agent, what are they better off doing? If this is going to be the outcome when the principal invests with the agent, the principal makes 0.1. They realize if they don't invest, they're going to make zero. They will not invest. So the equilibrium in this situation is going to be don't invest, because the principal realizes that the agent is going to appropriate. That means they're going to lose one. So they're better off not investing and losing zero. And the purpose of contract law is to set up the scenarios and have a contract so that we get the cooperative outcome in this particular scenario. So what the principal can do is actually contract with the agent and set up penalties in case they decide to breach the contract and not cooperate and walk off with the money. So if we go to figure 8.2, we can see here that under the scenario of breach or appropriate, the agent's contractually obligated to return the investment and pay damages of 0.5. So what this does is you can see that this changes the payoff in this scenario here of invest and appropriate or breach. Previously, we had that if the agent breached, the principal lost one while the agent gained one. Now we see that In the event of a breach, the original investment's returned plus damages are paid. So the principal gets 0.5, and now the agent loses 0.5. So let's take a look at this scenario now overall. If the principal invests with the agent, what are they better off doing? Well, if they breach, they're out 0.5. If they cooperate and invest and the investment doubles, they get 0.5. So the agent would much rather make 0.5 than lose 0.5. So therefore, under the scenario of invest, the agent's best strategy is to cooperate. So I want you to realize what a powerful tool having contractual language that stipulates the types of damages that have to be paid and how this moved our equilibrium from figure one from here to this point here. It's a more efficient outcome. Under don't invest, nothing, no surplus is created for either individuals, while under this scenario where there's contractual language for the return of the investment and the paying of damages causes the cooperative outcome to be the equilibrium. And this outcome, we add these two together, is equal to one, while this outcome is equal to zero. So this is the efficient outcome. And what I want you to realize in comparing figure 8.1 to 8.2 is how the introduction of penalties for breaching an agreement can cause an efficient outcome to occur.